How you feeling today, Abner?
What's up, man?
I'm good. Big boxing weekend. Tell me about this weekend. What can we expect?
It's gonna be a good fight, man. Starting by Friday. I'm going to Mexicali on Friday. My brother fights out there in Mexicali, and then I drive back that same night, you know, so I won't miss Carlos' fight.
What happened to the private jet?
Huh?
What happened? Oh, to the
man, I'm scared of private jets now. I won't say why, but like I said, I'm going to Mexicali on Thursday. Actually, I'm gonna be there for my brother's fight. Come back for Mamber Khan's and Carlos Molina's fight.
Break down that fight. What can we expect?
It's gonna be a good fight. You could expect a really good fight from Carlos. I mean, I know a lot of people don't know him. You know, never heard of him. But you know, he's one of those hidden talents. You know, he's never been out there exposed, and he's gonna get this exposure, and I'm sure he's gonna do a good job.
At the same time that this fight is going on in Texas, there's another fight that you're interested in. Jorge Arce and Nonito Donaire. Tell me about that fight.
That's what I said, man. Expect? Right now, I'm Nonito's biggest cheerleader, biggest fan right now, because I want him to win. You know, I want him to win. I want that fight to happen. I want to fight him. I want him to beat, you know, Arce, which I'm sure he will. Don't get me wrong. Arce is he's pulled a lot of upsets. He, you know, Wilfredo Vasquez is one of them. He beat, you know, a guy that a lot of people didn't think he was gonna beat. He's gonna give him, you know, good fight. But overall, I just think that Nonito has everything to beat him.
If Nonito's watching this, what would you tell him?
Nonito, hey, let's make the fight happen, man. Let's make this fight happen for the fans. I'm sure he wants the fight to happen too. He said it before, you know, me as a fighter, him as a fighter, we want this fight to really happen. But it's just really comes down to the promoters.
As a boxing champion, one of the best pound for pound fighters in the world, what did you think of Marquez's knockout over Pacquiao?
Wow, man, that was unbelievable, man. I almost broke down in tears, man. We were right there watching it at the house. We were just screaming, man. It was crazy, man. It was a, you know, believe me. I think Marquez is going down in history, man, as the biggest, you know, Mexican boxer as of now. He's up there, you know, with Julio Cesar Chavez, Salvador Sanchez, and now, you know, Marquez.
Can a fighter come back from a knockout like that?
Definitely can, but I mean, they asked me a little while ago if I was close to Pacquiao, what would I advise him, you know? And the people that are really close to him are already telling him, you know, just, you know, hang up the gloves already. The mom, the wife, and he should really listen. I mean, he gave us tremendous fights already. There's no need for him to come back. There's no need for another fifth fight. Why, you know? Even if they were to withdraw again, or even, you know, Pacquiao win, you know, there's no need for another, you know, hard punishment, you know, 12 rounds.
Last thing, Floyd said that he felt bad for men. What do you say about that?
I don't feel bad for him. That's not a thing to be feel bad for a champion. It's part of the sport. I mean, we're all exposed to it. I'm exposed to it. I might get knocked out, you know, who knows? It's a part of this beautiful sport, you know?
There you have it. I'm Lamar. Stay tuned. FinishTheReport.com. I'm Ellie Segback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Segback.